Now that you have installed WordPress, in this video, I will show you how to navigate the WordPress backend. The backend is your control room. From here, you can share the magic you create with the world. Or put less poetically, from the backend, you can add, edit, and remove the content on your website, as well as control what your site looks like. One thing to note before we start exploring the WordPress backend is that depending on your host, a couple of things may look slightly different in your WordPress installation. For example, your host may add different sample pages from the standard WordPress ones or install some plugins by default. We are working with a clean local install that is a completely basic setup. As you can already see on the screen, there is a lot you can do. In this video, I will briefly show you the options in the toolbar and the dashboard. In the next video, we will also see the options in the admin menu. We will go into much more detail on all of the options you see here in the other videos of this course. So let's begin. At the top of the screen, you can see the toolbar. This is your administrator toolbar, and it does not appear to people visiting your website. The first icon you see in the toolbar is the WordPress logo. From here, you can easily access WordPress-related sites and documents. Furthermore, by clicking on the name of your page, you will be taken to a screen that shows your homepage. This is what your visitors see when they go to your site. You could use this option to see what any changes you've made actually look like. Now let's go back to the toolbar and see the next option, which allows you quick access to the comments screen. Finally, the toolbar menu item titled New allows you to quickly write new posts, upload new media, write pages, and add new users. On the right side of the toolbar, you can edit your profile and log out. By clicking your login name or edit my profile, you will access the profile screen. Here, you can add some personal information such as your name and contact info. And most importantly, at the bottom of the screen is where you can change your password. Now that we've seen the toolbar, let's go to the more exciting part, the dashboard. When you first logged in with WordPress, you probably saw the welcome message. This message is within a box that we call a dashboard widget. When you are new to WordPress, everything may seem intimidating. So the WordPress developers created this widget with the intention to guide you through the most important first steps you can take in creating your site. Below, you can see that there are a few other widgets as well. Now, the widgets that you see on your dashboard are just the default ones. When you install plugins, other widgets may show up here as well, and that will allow you to manage your site in various ways. But let's quickly see what each of these default widgets provides. The At a Glance widget shows you what the current number of your posts, comments, and pages is. It also shows you what version of WordPress you are currently using, as well as the theme that you have activated. You can see that the options for posts, comments, and pages are blue. That means that you can click on them and be taken to their respective editing screens. For a more detailed preview of your posts and comments, there is the Activity widget. First, you can see the most recent published posts and their titles. Click on them and you will be taken to the post editing screen, where you can make changes if necessary. Below the recently published posts are the recent comments. The recent comment section in this widget allows you more than meets the eye. From here, you can see who commented and access their profile, as well as view the comment and the post it relates to. As you may be aware, comments sometimes need managing, and there are plenty of options for that here. For example, you can choose to unapprove, quickly reply, edit, mark as spam, delete, or view a comment. Lastly, this widget gives you an overview and quick access to all the comments on your website. Moving on to the Quick Drafts widget. If you have a new post idea and you want to jot it down quickly, you can do it via the Quick Drafts widget. All you need to do is enter a title, write a piece of text, and click Save. As the title suggests, this is just a draft and it will not be published on your site. Clicking on the link of the draft will take you to the post screen, where you can edit the draft and write a longer, complete version of your idea. Finally, in the WordPress News and Events, you are offered a quick glimpse into the WordPress world. By clicking on the links to meetups, WordCamps, and news, you can learn more about these topics. The widgets that we talked about are not static or set in stone. You can easily move, close, open, or delete them from your dashboard. If you hover over the top of one of the widgets, you can see a cross arrow appear. By clicking and holding your left mouse button and dragging the arrow, you can move these widgets around. You are free to arrange the widgets as you wish. If some of them are not useful to you, you can also choose to close them. Every widget has an arrow pointing upward in the upper right corner. By clicking on the arrow, you will see the widget close or collapse. The arrow is now pointing downwards. If you want to open the widget again, simply click on the downward pointing arrow. If you want to get rid of a widget completely, you can do that via the Screen Options. The Screen Options tab is located in the upper right corner below the Administrator tab. Click on it and you will see a menu that contains the widgets we discussed with ticked boxes next to them. If you untick a box of a respective widget, it will no longer be on your dashboard. If you want to put it back, just tick the box again. That is your dashboard and all you can do in it. In the next video, we will explore some more ways you can work with your site through the admin menu.